Oh my goodness, guys, look at what we have here. It's snowing. I can't believe it. It is not even November. It is absolutely incredible. But I will tell you that my husband's family would always tell him that it would snow before his birthday. And once again, they were right. His birthday's November 10th. All right, so I saw this morning and I had to run outside with my 70 to 300. And that's what I'm doing now. We still have fall colors on the tree, so it's really, really cool. And I don't know what I'm going to capture, but I'm hoping something. All right, let's do this. Okay, my backyard is really small. I always call it a postage stamp, but I have a few plants and the snow is landing on them. So I think I might just see what I can get. I have my tripod because even though there's snow and sometimes that makes things really bright, today is not that day. It is overcast and well, obviously it's cloudy, it's snowing, but it's somewhat dark. So I'm first going to just go and explore the plants and see what I can find. I already have a few ideas. Okay, I absolutely have to capture the raspberries and some of these flowers that are just covered in this light snowfall. It is so beautiful. Now, there's also, I don't think I can get close enough, but I might try. Behind me, there's this red fall tree and it's absolutely gorgeous. I might see if I can zoom in and get something there. If not, I might have to just go for a walk in the neighborhood. I'm gonna start with the raspberries. So I've got these raspberries here and they're really great, but I've got the 70 to 300 on, which means that I can't get up really, really close. I have to take it from farther away. And in this case, I think I might go back inside and get my 50 millimeter macro lens just because I think it might be a little bit more fun to focus close into the snow and get that detail. Not that I can't get the detail with the 70 to 300, but that's just what I feel like doing today. Thankfully, the way the lens is, means that it will still be protected from the snow because the lens is recessed into the thing. So let's get that. Okay, Minolta 1990s edition. And I love this lens, I really do. So I'm going to swap it out and keep shooting. One thing I am doing for sure is I am using minus one of an exposure value because even though it's a dark day, like I explained before, the snow is quite bright white. And so it kind of almost makes like an HDR situation where the snow is bright and the subject, if it's the raspberry, is darker. So I need to bring down the exposure so that the snow doesn't lose detail. Okay, turn off the camera, make a fast swap. And run this back inside. So now that I have the macro lens on, I can get really close. The other one was 1 meter away. This one is like, you know, I can get really close in there. So let's try this again. Woo. Maybe not so close to touch it, but really cool. Wow. Now I can see the individual snowflakes. I think I need a light. Be right back. Okay, I suppose it's macro photography. I could work with a flash, but I'm just gonna use this little handheld light that I have. It is really, really convenient. And I could put it on the top, but I think I just might hold it up to my subject. Yeah, I like that. I can adjust the strength of the light. And that helps to give me a faster shutter speed while things are moving. I'm gonna have to bring up my ISO as well. I'm gonna go to ISO 400 and see how we can get that. Ooh, the breeze is going. I'm playing with different f-stops. With you, when you've got macro, it's really easy to go too low and not have all of your subject in focus. You may not want all of your subject in focus, but if I do, I don't want to have missed it. So gorgeous. This wasn't planned, but I just want to encourage you, if conditions suddenly become incredible like this, just go for it. Just grab, you know, coat and hat and head out with the with your camera. All right. I would love to just be handheld here because honestly, I could take like 5 million pictures. Now I have these pink flowers. why I'm not using the 2 second timer. It's a tough call. I think the reason I'm not is because everything is sort of moving, and if I use the 2 second timer, I have to guess when things are going to slow down, and I don't want to do that. I just want to be able to press the button. So I'm being really, really careful with the button as I press it, and it may not always work out, but ISO 800, 1/125th of a second, f4.5, but as I said, I'm playing with the f-stop. That's really beautiful. Ooh, the wind is blowing it. So always be careful when you put your tripod down again after doing macro, because the legs, I have them in different positions, and so if I just pick it up and put it down, sometimes the legs are not stable, and I've had times before when my camera has almost fallen over. So at ISO 800, I may be able to do some handheld shots. And so that's what I'm going to try and do. And I just love, love, love this weather. Look at it. It's just incredible. It's awesome. So I want to share with you guys that I have the most awesome stuff coming up to show you. First of all, this camera is my new GoPro Hero9, and I'm so excited to be using it, and I'm trying it out as a vlogging camera. It is, it's exciting to me that I might have something new and even more portable than the small Canon M50 that I was using before. And yeah, if you like this video, that means it went well. And also, I had Valorette send me some winter gloves, and I went for the most Arctic, because today in the snow here is honestly, this is nothing compared to what I'm gonna get here in Canada. And if you've watched my videos, you know. So minus 40 degrees, I think I might be ready. And I can't wait to show you those gloves in action and to review them for you. And finally, I also have a microphone set to share with you. And I'm actually not sure if this video is gonna go up first or if the microphone video is gonna come up first. But this time though, I have a special guest, and it is the beautiful Kara, who I went to Palm Springs with. And we will be bringing you some fall colors and the microphone review. So you guys, this is absolutely incredible. So the tips for what I was doing today: have some extra light if needed. This is a very inexpensive light, and I love it. I got it on Amazon. It was like $15. It has a cold shoe mount, and I love it because it also has another cold shoe mount on the top. So if you need to put it on top of something and then still put like a mic or something on top of it, you can do that. So I've used it for years now, and it was so cheap. I'll put the link to it in, or at least I will list it in the description. And you might have to use a higher ISO depending on your lighting for the snow and the macro. And you may need to lower your exposure value a bit to get the detail in the snow. Also, I think it's important to keep an eye on your f-stop. If you're using a macro lens like mine, you may need to increase your f-stop to make sure that you get enough of a depth of field. So have a fantastic day, you guys. This is just beautiful. I hope that you're having a great day. And if you can only go out in your backyard, that's amazing. If you can only stay in your house, that's amazing too. There's so many macro opportunities. And just enjoy. All right. Thanks for coming along, guys. If you haven't subscribed, I'd love it if you would come along, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.